Hello students, welcome back. Before moving to the class, let me start with the proverb. Successful is not a key to happiness, but happiness is a key to successful. So if you love what you're doing, definitely you will be happy and successful. Today's lesson is the 7th standard social science economics unit 1 production.
Economics unit 1 production. What is production? Production is the process of changing the raw materials into finished product. For example, cotton is the raw material. With the help of cotton, we produce bed, pillow, cushion, etc. That is finished product. Next, production in economics refers to the creation of those goods and services which have exchange value. It means the creation of utilities. Utilities means it is the quality of the goods to satisfy a want. Look at the picture. Fruit is given as the input. After production, it becomes as a juice, that is output. Types of utility. Form utility. If the physical form of commodity is changed, its utility may increase. Example, cotton increases if it is converted into cloths. Place utility. If a commodity is transported from one place to another, its utility may increase. That is, for example, if rice transported from Tamil Nadu to Kerala, its utility will be more. Time utility. If the commodity is stored for future usage, its utility may increase. For example, agricultural commodities like paddy, wheat, etc. are stored for the regular uses of consumers throughout the year. Look at the picture. Form utility. When a tailor converts a cloth into garment, that is the example for form utility. The next, place utility. Transportation of coal from mines to industry. That is, wherever the coal is needed, it is transported. So that is place utility. And time utility. Time utility happens when goods are stored in plenty and supplied when they are in shortage. See, one side it is plenty and supplied whenever it is needed. Types of production. There are three types of production. Primary production, secondary production, territory or service production. Let me go through under each heading. Primary production. Primary production is carried out by extractive industries like agriculture, forestry, fishing, mining, and oil extraction. These industries are engaged in such activities as extracting the gifts of nature from the earth's surface. Secondary production. This includes production in manufacturing industry, turning out semi-finished and finished goods from raw materials and intermediate goods, that is conversion of iron ore into finished steel. For example, engineering, building and cotton industry. Tertiary production. Industries under this sector produce all those services which enable the finished goods to be put in the hands of consumers. Example, banking, insurance, transport, communication, defense and education. Factors of production. When there is a production, a process of transformation takes place. Inputs are converted into an output. It is an economic term that describes the input used in the production of goods or services in order to make an economic profit. There are two types of factors, primary factors and derived factors. Land. Land includes land plus anything that comes from the land. Land as a factor of production refers to all those natural resources or gifts of nature which are provided free to man. The primary resources are involved in production. It refers to anything that comes from the earth. Characteristic of land. Land is a free gift of nature because with the help of land, man has to make efforts in order to acquire other factors of production. Next, land is fixed in supply. Yes, land is fixed and limited. It cannot be increased or decreased. Next, land is imperishable. That is, land is not destructible. Thus, it cannot go out of existence. Land is a primary factor of production. In any kind of production process, we have to start with land. For example, in agriculture, crops are produced on land. Next, land is immovable. Land cannot be transported from one place to another. Land has some original indestructible, which a man cannot destroy. Its fertility may be varied, but it cannot be destroyed completely. Land differs in fertility. Fertility of land differs on different pieces of land. One piece of land produce more and the other produce less. Labor. Labor refers to human effort. Labor is the human input into the production process. Specifically, the effort that we put for producing goods and services. According to Alfred Marshall, defines labor as the use of body or mind, partly or wholly, with the view to secure an income, apart from the pleasure derived from the work. Look at the picture. Missionary work, the labors of working under missionary, physical work and mind work.
Characteristic of labor. Labor is more perishable than other factors of production. That means labor cannot be stored. Next, labor is an active factor of production. Neither land nor capital can yield much without labor. Labor is not homogeneous. That is, skill and knowledge vary from person to person. Next, labor cannot be separated from the laborer. That is, work cannot be separated from a person. Next, labor is mobile. That means man moves from one place to another, from a low paid occupation to a high paid occupation. That's why it is called as labor is mobile. Next, individual labor has only limited bargaining power. That is, he cannot fight with his employer for a rise in wages or improvement in workplace conditions. Division of labor. The concept division of labor was introduced by the Adam Smith in his book, An Enquiry into the Nature and Causes of Wealth of Nations. Actually, division of labor means dividing the work into different labors. Example, a tailor stitches a shirt in full. In the case of garment exporters, cutting of cloth, stitching of hands, body, collars, holes for buttons, stitching of buttons, etc. are done independently by different workers. Therefore, they are combining different parts into a whole shirt. Merits and demerits of division of labor. Under merits, it improves efficiency of labor when labor repeats doing the same task. Under demerits, repetition of the same task makes labor to feel that the work is monotonous and stale. Under merits, time and materials are put to the best and most efficient use. Under demerits, reduce the growth of handicrafts and the worker loses the satisfaction of having made a commodity in full. Capital. Capital is the man-made physical goods used to produce other goods and services. In the ordinary language, capital means money, that is money invested for a business. According to Marshall, capital consists of those kinds of wealth other than free gifts of nature which yield income. Forms of capital. Physical capital or material resources. For example, money invested in machinery, tools, building, etc. Next, money capital or monetary resources. Example, bank deposit, shares and securities, etc. Next is human capital or human resources. Example, investment in education, training and health, etc. Characteristic of capital. Capital is a passive factor of production. That is, always will not be active. Money will not be in active position because there will be a profit or loss. Next, capital is man-made factor. After earning only, man gets the money. So, it is a man-made factor. Next, capital is not an indispensable factor of production. That is, it is not an indispensable. It is always dispensable factor only. Capital has the highest mobility. So, money can transfer from one place to another. That's why it is called as highest mobility. Capital is productive and capital lasts over time. Capital involves present sacrifice to get future benefit. So now if you are sacrificing the money in investing anything else, the future there will be a benefit. Entrepreneur. Entrepreneur means businessman. An entrepreneur is a person who combines the different factors of production, that is land, labor and capital, in the right proportion and initiates the process of production and also bears the risk involved in it. Characteristic of entrepreneur. Identifying profitable investable opportunities, that is expecting a profitable income. Next, deciding the location of the production of unit, that is selecting the place for production. Next, making innovation, find something new. Next is deciding the reward payment, regarding bonus, increment, etc. That is called reward payment. Next, taking risk and facing uncertainties. That is facing risk in the business. A short recap. Production is the process of combining various material inputs in order to make something for consumption. Utility means want satisfying power of a product. There are three types of production: primary production, secondary production, tertiary or service production. Next, factors of production: land, labor, capital, entrepreneur. Students, I hope you understood everything. Be safe and take care. Bye.